While addressing Parliament after the budget speech, President Yoweri Museveni called for a halt on public borrowing if the country is to overcome the choking public debt burden. He noted that time has come to borrow less or not at all.
The way forward is that we should borrow less, and I'm glad the minister talked about that, or not borrow at all. With the discipline, we do not have to borrow at all.
Out of the 52.7 trillion budget, the government will spend 27.58 trillion shillings on debt repayment and other outstanding commitments. Mr. Museveni expressed concerns that some loans which were borrowed by the government were not necessary and blamed government officials in the Ministry of Finance for misleading the country.
The 52 billion trillion you are talking about, 17 trillion of it is to pay debts. Amabanja. Many of these debts were being pushed by the neo-colonial public servants until recently, when I put down my foot and insisted on approving every loan. That's why you hear that these loans take time now to be approved, because I insisted I must approve of every loan, external loan.
Public debt is projected to accumulate to 88.9 trillion shillings in 2 weeks' time, according to the latest information from the Ministry of Finance. Museveni says Uganda Revenue Authority collections are still too low to support economic growth, and says 13% tax to GDP ratio is not making sense compared to the tax to GDP ratio for European countries.
Now, what I want the NRM cadres to understand is that in order to do the industrialization I talked about, we don't have to use government money. The government money has already been used on the basics. Infrastructure, security, and so on. The strategy is to handle well the private sector. Private sector can help us industrialize our country.
Museveni's short speech, which was delivered online, put emphasis on the need to prioritize value addition on locally produced products such as coffee, cotton, timber, cocoa, fish products, among others.
The effort must be made to add value to all our products. Because this is what is lacking now. To add value to all our products, add value to coffee, please. Why? Because you will get money more than 10 times more when you add value to coffee than the way we are selling it now. To cotton, timber, cocoa, even fish products, although the factories are producing fish, fillet, and so on, but we can add more value, apparently. Gold.
He emphasized that the continued exportation of raw materials is a reason for the stagnated growth of African economies, and said they surrender too much wealth to Europe.
Industrialization is aimed at two missions. Number one, import substitution. Mulekerao okusaka, don't import, make locally. But also export promotion.
Museveni also spoke out on his health condition and scoffed at those who reported that he is in critical condition in the ICU.
I want to thank all the Ugandans who have been praying for me. I've been watching you praying for me at the National Chairman's office, Babaranda and Hadija Muzukuru, praying in All Saints Church, praying and signing the board here near the gate, and all the others who have been wishing me good luck. I appreciate really. It's good to know that I am not as bad as some people try to make me, and that there are Ugandans who appreciate.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.